Hello everyone, welcome to Betrayer. This is a rather creepy action-adventure FPS type game set in the year 1604. You sail to a colony on the Virginia coast and find some rather disturbing things. It's made by a bunch of veterans from Monolith Productions, the people who worked on the No One Lives Forever series and the Fear series. It's also available from a bunch of different places, including Steam, so I'll have links to all of that in the description. Let's jump in. Alright, here we go. This is as far as I've gotten into the game. I've just started it up just to tweak the settings, so I don't know what to expect. Yeah, the look of everything might be burning your eyes, by the way. It's a very, very high contrast sort of look. It's really harsh on the eyes. I actually remember hearing a lot about the graphic style, and I think they were thinking of changing it or something like that. However, they did add in the ability to change it if you want. This is the default look. But you actually can change it. For example, if I change it to about 1.6, about 1.2, and turn color saturation up, it looks pretty much normal. But since this is how they obviously intend for it to be played, since that's the default, I'm gonna leave it on this for at least a little while. I don't know, I'm not quite sold on it. It's really harsh to look at. But I'll roll with it, and we'll see what happens. So I think I can break these. Yeah, there's some stuff inside of here. A longbow arrow. Treasure chest. Not sure where I'm going to be spending money. Maybe I can find a shop. Some more arrows. And some more coins, okay. A little bit of ammo, a little bit of money. Yeah, another thing I've tweaked from the default state, by the way, is in the options game, yeah, death loot drop. So I'm actually gonna drop my loot on death, and unless I pick it up before my next death, kind of Dark Souls sort of style, I will lose it forever. That's actually off by default, but I turned it on. Because I think they originally had it on, but they disabled it in one of the patches or something like that. Maybe they thought it was too hard. But I've got it on. Should add a bit of extra tension. Alright, let's take a look around. See if there's anything hidden in here. Nope. It's so high contrast, it just looks like a void. A black hole in the corner. Probably nothing to do but just continue on forwards. Still, though, I can't shake the feeling there's some sort of hidden loot around here. No. I love the way everything blows in the wind. It's really, really cool looking. The sound of the seagulls. And I'm assuming that was my ship. Judging by its not-so-good state and everything washed ashore, I'm thinking I can't go back to it. I'm kind of stuck here. Let's move on ahead. It's a little hut up there. Left shift to sprint. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the art style pretty much just burns my eyes, to be honest. It's really harsh. Everywhere there's a shadow, it's almost like you can't even see the ground. A little bit more money. really do love the way everything blows in the wind. It's so cool. Hello there. What are you shooting at? Is that a message? It is. I do not know who you are or why you've come here, but you should turn back lest you become trapped in this place as I am. Well, unfortunately, I think I'm stuck here. Notes. Lest you become trapped. So I do believe this game is kind of open world. Yeah, it's a whole inventory system, some clues. People. Maiden in red. A young woman in a red cloak appeared along the path from the shore and sent a note attached to an arrow. She seems to be warning me away. I would really like a weapon. I think that's a weapon. Is that a bow? I think it's a bow? Yes, it's a bow. Yes. Dear sir or madam, I have come into possession of a number of fine items of exceptional quality and indisputable value. As a token of my good faith, I offer you a free bow in hopes that you may survive long enough to become a regular customer. Arrows will be free for a limited time, as well. Beware that they may sometimes deflect from armored enemies, so be sure to carry plenty and recover them when you can. I will put my trust in your honor to leave payment for whatsoever else you choose to purchase. Respectfully, John Howe, Merchant. You know, I like this merchant's idea. Offer you a bow in hopes that you may survive long enough to become a regular customer. See, that's an investment. That is an investment. You have to realize if somebody dies, they can't pay you money. So if you keep them alive, and you give them a gift, maybe you'll reap some rewards. I like you, John Howe. Okay. So you said they're free for a while, huh? I've got 16 in my inventory. Can't carry item. Stock unlimited. I could buy a shoddy longbow. But wait, shoddy longbow, is that really better than the bow I've already got? Probably not. Oh, I can hold more arrows if I get the longbow quiver, I think. Okay, what do I have? Oh, I have a cracked longbow. Alright, let's take a look. 30 damage, range long. 30 damage, range long, fast, deflect chance 20%. I think this is better. Yeah, it does 5 more damage. I'm gonna go ahead and buy it. There we go. Purchased shoddy longbow. Money well spent. On crap. Yeah, it's better. Drag items here to scrap. Can I move these around? Yes. Don't think I need two bows, but what the heck? Might as well have them up there. So number one for that bow, number two for the other one. Oh, I can't do the Counter-Strike thing where you switch between weapons instantly. Okay, I think I'm good there. Did I get a new note? People? Oh yeah, John Howe. A traveling merchant who barters weapons and equipment. Okay, 16 of 16 shots. How does this work? Zoom in with right-click. That's my iron sights, so to speak. Okay, I can recover them apparently, so let's test fire. Where did it go? It looked like it broke. Okay. Wait, can I not pick you up? Oh, do you just pick them up by walking over them? Oh, you do? Okay. Okay, so if you just click once, it's a really short, little, crappy shot, and if you hold it down, you shoot further. Makes sense. Pretty simple. Not sure about the arc, though. Like, how much I'm gonna have to lead my target, how fast they are, that sort of stuff. Because your well-being is important to me, both fiscally and sentimentally, I feel I should advise you that enemies are easiest to slay if you can catch them unaware, for their rage makes them stronger. Shots to the head will also inflict more grievous injury than those to the trunks or limbs. Please rely on me whenever you find yourself in need of deadlier implements of warfare. Cordially, John Howe, Merchant. I like this John Howe even more now. Aw, it didn't stick in like the one that the Maiden in Red shot. Holy crap, that thing flies far. You'd think it would stick into wood, huh? It's weird. Oh, hi. Oh, crap, it saw me. Okay. Oh, you have a gun. I didn't realize you had a gun. Crude pistol. The heck is that? Gold doubloon. 25... I was gonna say 25 bucks. Well, it's not dollars, but 25 monies. Okay, so enemies can see you from pretty far away. See if there's anything around here. Doesn't appear so. Not that I'd necessarily be able to see it unless it was glowing red, which if I could interact with it, I suppose it would be. Interactable things tend to glow red in this game, they seem. Seems like. Let's go ahead and put that there. How many shots do I have for it? 10. Alright. Yeah, so very old weapons, very slow reload. You gotta be really careful with your shots. I remember seeing that and hearing about that from the previews and whatnot. Okay, it's also not even very fast. It's a surprising delay before that hit that tree. So the bow is much faster to shoot than a gun. Much faster. All treasure chests found. Journal updated. All chests found. Use your compass to locate nearby dropped items, such as loot or arrows. Listen for a distinctive ricochet sound if it is being ricocheted from the armor of an enemy. Okay. Looking at my compass. Guess there's nothing to pick up. The weapons you recover from slain adversaries are generally of poor quality, being both feebler and more cumbersome to employ than you may desire. The weapons I offer are guaranteed to do more harm and do it faster. Fort Henry. Okay, do I need to do something? Is it loading? Is it loading? Okay. That took a strangely large amount of time, considering the game's on an SSD, but oh well. Oh, where'd I come from? I'm assuming I came from behind myself, so let's go this way. Throw tomahawk. Do I only have one? Well, hold on, let's see what's in here. Big fat nothing. It was remiss of me not to mention that enemies are more likely to discover you if you are moving. Crouching makes you significantly harder to detect and allows you to move quietly. Use the wind to your advantage. Gusts will mask your footsteps, making it easier to run up behind your foes without alerting them. Okay. Mm-hmm. Where's my tomahawk? Did it list that anywhere in my inventory? I don't see the tomahawk. Well, I know I've got it. Yeah, I've just got one. Okay, I hear an enemy. Let's be nice and quiet. Nice and quiet. I'm not sure which way it's looking. Okay, it's looking to the right. Okay. Well, that didn't work. Fuck. Alright, where did those arrows go? My god. That was a bad shot. I'm still not sure how fast or how much they arc down. Let's see. Where even is the arrow? I don't even see it going. Oh, I think it's going above my crosshair, actually. I'm gonna keep testing this, because I gotta get this right. Yeah, it's actually hitting above my crosshair from this distance. Okay, it's starting to arc at that point. So I think I overshot. I think I shot an arrow over its head. Yeah, it's hitting above my crosshair. Okay. All right. I wonder if I can avoid getting shot by the gun. Like, if I jump out of the way, or maybe it just always hits me. Not sure how good of a shot they are. I just love the feeling of being like a hunter in the woods, just amongst all this grass, the wind blowing in the trees. Listening to it, using it to my advantage, to hunt my foes, like that. Very cool. Nice feeling. Don't see any more enemies. I do see a note, though. Page scrap. Several among the council are wary of treating with the naturals, but I believe I have convinced them of the necessity, for we cannot assume that Sir Christopher will outfit a resupply fleet with sufficient urgency to ensure it reaches us from England before we have no more need of it. We will starve before spring without succor. Succor? Not quite sure what that word means. Treating with the naturals. See an enemy far, far down there. But first, let's take a look here. Okay. It's welcoming me in. Thank you. What the hell is... Oh, it's the sound of the flag. Okay, there's something over here. Grave. Reginald Milet, a true gentleman. Oh, there's a fast travel system? Oh, okay. That's where I started, this is where I've gone to, okay. clue. Indian arrows that were most likely intended for the head of a sentry. There's a clue system? I guess I'm supposed to find out what happened. My dear sir or madam, I hope that the bow I gave you has been of reasonable service, but I would encourage you to consider some of my finer wares. I accept coin or barter as you see fit. Please check back from time to time to see what new items I may have acquired. Whoa. Okay, a lot of stuff. Some very, very cheap stuff here. Shortbow, longbow. I have a longbow, right? I think. What's the difference between a shortbow and a longbow, exactly? Is a shortbow just smaller? Alright, I'll come back later. Can I sell my stuff? Sell price 15, yes I can. How do I sell it? Scrap? I'm not sure if that worked, I wasn't looking at my money. I think it did. It made a money sound. It appears a bell was mounted here. It is probably used to call the colonists to prayer and to signal danger. Drinking from a barrel will restore your health and refill your water skin if you have one. I don't. A small trowel well suited to breaking up hard soil. Alright, so I can dig for stuff, I suppose. I suspect I can't go indoors. The Indian king, whom they call a Werence, was much pleased to our gift, much pleased by our gift of tools and trinkets, and gave us in return an abundance of corn and bear meat, which is an excellent victual. I don't know what a victual is. I don't think I've ever heard that word. Interesting. I grasp the meaning well enough, though. What the hell happened to you? Been turned to stone. Though the figure appears human, it is only ash and ember. Oh, it's not stone, it's just ash. Crude charm of soldiery. How do charms work? Oh, no, the trowel's a... Wait, is the trowel a tool I can use, or is it just a clue? Or both? Might be both. There we go. Oh, it's equipped. All right. Reload muskets, pistols, and crossbows 5% faster. Cool. Oh, there's the bell. An ornate bell. It appears to be in good condition. It could probably be remounted from where it hung. I know exactly where to put that. Something appears to be buried here, but the soil is so rocky that it will take more than a trowel to dig it up. I know just the thing. That didn't work. Okay, like a shovel, maybe? Pistol load. Nice. Another ash figure. More Indian arrows. Either there was a large-scale attack or several smaller skirmishes. Those are shortbow arrows. I can't open it. You can drink from water skin to restore yourself at any time. Be sure to refill it at open barrels. Oh, did I just get one? Oh yeah, I just got one. Heal Z. According to our prisoner, the Spaniards seek to destroy settlements that might be used for privateering against their treasure fleets, and will surely come at us again. We need reinforcements if we are to repel further attacks. Yet another ash figure. What could these be? Take more than a trowel to dig it up. Alright, so I've got two things I can dig up. If I can just find the right tool. Let's go ahead and remount it. Now I can ring it. Ooh, do I want to? I guess I pretty much have to, don't I? Okay, I see two pluses on the bottom right of the screen. I'm guessing that means I can heal two times from my water skin. That's my guess. Kinda wanna just explore. Nah, let's ring the bell. Whoa. Okay, did not expect that. I can hear it reverberating more and more and more. I hear noises. Ugh, dug up what appears to be a human eyeball, though it feels more like a stone. It is strangely heavy and warm in your hand. It seems that you can see things you couldn't before. What the hell? Collected an eye. Still can't dig this up, right? No. The Lord Governor has determined that we cannot spare any men to send to Fort Henry, for we are harried constantly by the naturals, who have recently grown more hostile towards us for unknown reasons. They didn't get any backup. That's unfortunate. What the hell is that? Dug up a petrified ear. Like the eye you found, it is heavy and warm. It seems you can hear things you couldn't before. What the hell? Petrified tongue. It seems you can now speak to those who couldn't hear you before. I guess I can go talk to the ghost now? Where is Martha? Who is Martha? My wife. Who are you? I'm Captain William Eastgrove. Where did you last see her? On a hillside. We were sitting together. I was holding her hand, talking about our son. I shall find her for you if I can. Whoa! Hi. I hate to interrupt, but who are you talking to? I was speaking to a wraith named William Eastgrove. You know, normal things. But I see no one. He appeared in the dark when I rang the bell, and vanished when daylight returned. In the dark? How can that be? The sun has not moved in the sky. Are you certain of what you saw? I couldn't see him until I found the strange eyeball. That is an unsettling discovery, and an odd thing to pick up. Hmm. I personally find the tongue more unsettling. I think I find them all pretty much equally unsettling. It is an odd thing to pick up, I suppose. I thought it might be useful, cause... game. I don't think that would have occurred to me, although you seem to have been right. Who are you? I can't remember. I'm sure that I lived here, for this place is familiar, but it's like a dream. I can't quite recall. Do you remember anything? My sister. I've been searching for her, but I can't remember her name either. Perhaps she is hiding from the Spaniards, for they seem more beasts than men. Spaniards? I've seen no one but you since I awoke in the forest days ago. I assure you that there are no Spaniards here. Not anymore. One of us is not seeing the world as it is. Then I hope that it is you, for I do not wish to see the things you speak of. What did the Wraith want of you, anyway? He is searching for his wife. I would help you find her, but it is hard to track what one cannot see, and I must seek my sister. Please let me know if you see her. We are twins, so she should be easy to recognize. Where shall I find you if I have news to report? Let us meet in this fort for now. I would also like to learn the outcome of your search for the Wraith's wife. I can't help but worry what's become of her. Very well. Okay. I remember we lived here for a time after we arrived. There were many skirmishes with the naturals in those days, until finally we made peace with them. Do you think these ash figures were the people who lived here? Which ash figures? Have you not seen figures of ash that look like people? Are you trying to scare me? That sounds horribly unsettling. But I've seen no such thing. She can't see any of it. None of it. Is she the one that sent me the note that she's trapped, or was that her sister? She didn't even mention it at all. Okay, so holding hands with his wife on a hillside. I can't say those are the best directions. A hillside. There are many hills. And many sides. Take a look at the map. Yep. Listen X. Whoa. I think it's coming from here. Yeah, okay, I'm hearing something this direction. Okay, so the ear allows me to hear where something important is. I love that wind. Beautiful. I guess I'll head in that direction. Something over there as well. But no, I'm definitely hearing it from this direction. Definitely. Let us see what we can find. Let's not follow the path directly. Let's stay on the side. Whoa. Oh. Scared me. Okay, what if I take down the harshness a little bit? Like, the dark intensity is kinda ridiculous. How about that? Does that look better? I mean, now it's mostly just like black and white, but it's not as ridiculously harsh as it was before. That's a bit more pleasant. I see an enemy in the distance. Just listen again. Make sure I'm going the right direction. It's actually over there. Okay, and I'm looking east. So I'm going this way. Let's stay out of their sight. Common pistol. Ooh, that's better than a crude pistol, for sure. Much more damage. Range is still very short, though. Yeah, so let's go ahead and scrap this. Let me see if it does give me money. It does, okay. Cool. Let's listen again. That sounded very close this time, and it's definitely that direction, but before that, let's see what this is. It is shrouded in corruption. Okay, what can I do about that? I've discovered a carved pillar tainted with some reeking, unhealthsome corruption. Tormented voices seem to whisper from within the post itself. Oh wait, right here? Dug up a valuable looking distinctive necklace of gold and topaz. Among the stones you find the remains of a woman. Strands of long dark hair are still attached to the moldering skull. There's a bullet hole in the forehead. Damn. Well, I guess I found what I came here for. It's not good news, though. Not that I really expected to find good news. Grave is unmarked. Alright, let's head back. I remember seeing... Oh, shit, I just hurt myself. What was it to heal, by the way? Was it Z? Yeah, Z, there we go. Looks like this one's corrupted, too. Yep, corruption. Looks like there's a pathway that goes up here. Is it a pathway? Not really. I'm trying to stay high up so I can see any enemies before they see me. Yeah, I remember I saw an enemy down here. Maybe he wandered away. It's like right around there. Alright, well, let's go tell the ghost what happened to his wife. Oh, it's the sound of the flag again. It keeps scaring me. And how do I know you're not your sister if you're twins? Are you still helping your wraith friends? Yes. I'll be back. Oh, I gotta ring the bell, don't I? Do you recognize this topaz necklace? It is Martha's. I gave it to her after our son was born. I found it near the remains of a woman who had been shot. Now I remember. I found her on a hillside to the south, on a warm and pleasant morning. I sat beside her, holding her hand and talking about her son as she died. It was you who buried her? Yes. I thought she would rest better there than near the fort, so I covered her over with stones. I meant to return to dig her a proper grave, but someone stole our only spade, and a trowel would not suffice. Okay, so I need to dig her a proper grave. For that I need a spade, and also to dig up these things around here, I also need a spade. Where could my sister be? I don't know. I'm sorry, I don't. Okay, what if I do this again? And I listen. It's coming from here. Is there something I can do with the bell ringing? I'm not sure if I want to go towards that noise. The stalks of that tree were all, like, bloody red. Here we go. Ooh, the corruption is gone. Just by going near it? It has been cleansed of corruption. Okay. I guess I should head for the other one. I think it's over this way. I don't like going around with the world all weird like this. That didn't do anything. Maybe I don't shoot you. Oh, okay, hi. Where is John? Who is John? My son. Where did you last see him? My husband. Carrying him through the gate. I was so relieved to see them, so happy. Who are you? I don't know. I can't remember. This topaz necklace is yours? Yes. Then you are Martha Eastgrove. I remember now. You have given me back my name. What happened to you? I remember staring at the barrel of a pistol, fearful, but strangely calm, and I began to pray. Found was once a finely made and likely expensive pistol, now badly rusted and useless. I guess I helped her move on. Okay, there's another totem down here, right? Yeah. Whoa! The fuck is that? Okay, that's an enemy. The corruption is gone, but the enemies aren't gone. Yeah, I don't think I can really avoid it. Getting hit, seems like. Ooh, there goes most of my arrows. Okay, got a lot of them back. Cleansed of corruption. Not sure what that does, really. I mean, obviously cleansing corruption is good, but... in practical terms, what that means, I don't really know. Whoa. Oh, Jesus. Okay, let's see where the noise takes me. This way. Yeah, I think I just need to go back at this point. Oh, shit. I could just keep going. Okay, use cover. Cover's very important, obviously. I think I get all my arrows back? Yeah, I think I got all of them back, okay. So as long as you're really careful with your shots, you can get your ammo back. You know, every time I shoot the bow, I want to press reload immediately afterwards. But you don't reload a bow, not like... I'm thinking, like, Counter-Strike or something. I gotta unlearn my Counter-Strike skills. Whoa. Where is it? It's on me. Maybe it didn't. Maybe it just spawned. Martha is anxious about your son. She was so desperate with worry, as I was. A group of us went into the woods to search for him. Then I heard Gregory Ward calling out to him and knew he was safe. She remembers you carrying him through the gate. I was telling him he mustn't play outside by himself, for there are too many dangers in these woods. I told him he must never make his mother worry. Do you recognize this pistol? I remember taking it from my son's hand, pulling open his fingers when he refused to let go, telling him he must never use it without my permission. I found your pistol near Martha's remains. It was missing when I awoke. I was panicked. I ran outside and shouted for the sentry. He had just come on duty, so I woke Gregory Ward to ask him what he had seen during his watch. What did he say? I can't remember. I'm hearing something very far away over here. John Shrivener, killed by a Spaniard. What has roused you from your slumber? I am sundered and cannot rest. Sundered? Profaned, defiled, robbed of my head by a demon who means to wear my skull as an ornament. Then I shall seek to get it back. You know, I'm curious what this does. There's this other world gain. Yeah, it makes it brighter in the other world. That removes too much of the atmosphere. I don't know. I mean, once it goes through YouTube compression, it might look like a mess to you, but it looks pretty good to me. It's not happy. It doesn't want to let go. Whew. The wind has shifted, dispersing the stench of corruption from the area. Yeah, there's something on my compass at the top. Forest edge. This way. Shot another one over him. Can't find it. I have lost my way in this darkness. The sound of the bell will lead you home. Go home. Go home. Okay, how far am I? Not too far. I'm north. So if I go south, should be good. But hold on. There's something listed on the map this way. I wonder why. Oh, it's just the location. Yeah, that's not somewhere I need to go. It's just telling me I can go there. Yep, and the size of the bar indicates how close it is. Okay, that's pretty cool. Sure, I have anything new to tell him, do I? Edmund Gotham still hasn't returned from patrol. Where did you last see him? We met by chance near Dodd's Hill. It was nearly dark. He said he'd found a Spanish encampment and showed me where it was. Who are you? Gregory Ward. William Eastgrove woke you to ask what you had seen during your watch. I told him his wife left the fort, saying she was going for a short walk. I thought it strange that she was wearing a fine necklace for such an occasion. He remembers you calling out John's name when you were searching the woods. I spied the boy in a clearing, aiming a pistol at a tree. He pulled the trigger, but nothing happened. So we went to peer into the barrel. Oh my god. I was shouting at him by then, running towards him as fast as I could. I don't remember hearing the shot, just the smoke obscuring him. Oh my god. Your son accidentally shot himself. I remember now. A group of us went into the woods to search for him. I heard Gregory Ward calling out to him and knew he was safe. Then a shot rang out. I remember taking my pistol from my son's hand, pulling open his fingers when he refused to let go, telling him he must never use it without my permission. And then I closed his eyes and went to tell Martha that her son was dead. I remember carrying him through the gate, telling him he mustn't play outside by himself, for there are many dangers in these woods. I told him he must never make his mother worry, and I saw her relieved smile, crumbling into despair. Gregory Ward says that Martha left the fort early, wearing her topaz necklace. I knew what she meant to do. Why she had taken my pistol. Why she had worn that necklace. I was running through the woods when I heard the shot. Just like before. She took her own life. That's why I buried her there, so that the chaplain would not speak of her as a sinner bound for damnation. I did not want her to be thought of that way. How did you explain her disappearance? I told the truth, that she wandered into the woods and never came home. What an incredibly sad tale. I don't think I have anything more to say to them, do I? No. Oh, my eyes have to adjust after all that darkness now, so bright. I never felt comfortable in this place. I wonder if something terrible happened here. I have a gift for you? I do? What is it? Oh, a necklace of gold and topaz that belonged to Martha Eastgrove. It is very beautiful. Why are you giving it to me? Because you are also very beautiful. Now is not exactly the time for romance. I'm kind of facing demons here. It didn't match my complexion. I'm sure you are being hard on yourself. It would look lovely on you. Does that mean she didn't want it, or... Are you fighting lots of battles? I'm sure they're exciting and perilous. Yes, they're... History books will be written about my tales of shooting skeletons. I have learned the fate of a wraith. What did you learn? Martha Eastgrove shot herself in grief over the accidental death of her son. In doing so, she doubled her husband's grief and made him bear it alone. I think she was very selfish. I guess there's nothing to do now but move on and see what else I can find around here. Let's take a look at what I've got. Hold on, let me check my inventory, see if I need to sell anything. Nope, nothing to sell. 200 loot, okay. I could definitely use some more arrows, no doubt about that. I've got 8. Let's buy a couple more. Yeah, I can't afford anything else. Oh, there's the enemy. Oh, I should heal myself. I totally forgot to heal myself. I'm not sure how much of their finding out about me is based on vision versus sound. In other words, can I run if I'm behind them, for example? Don't know. Well, if I'm gonna get nice and close... I love the clink of their armor. Oh, shit. Where did that come from? Somewhere over here. I think I see it. Oh, Jesus. Alright, so that hit his armor a bunch of times. I heard the clinks. Okay, got most of my ammo back, I think. I think I missed one. What did I find there? think I found a, like, a broken weapon or something. Dance for me! It just looks silly. Alright. Listen. It's this direction? Hmm. It would be in this direction. I would think it'd be over here. I saw something down there. Oh, there's one. Remember, I will lose my equipment if I die. No, there's a pathway up here. Where's this lead? Where am I looking? Southwest? So I'm going this way? Yeah. Whoa. I'm going up into here. Dodd's Hill destination. This morning we could find no trace of Tabitha Markley. The sentry saw no one coming or going. Nor was there any sign of struggle. Even her sister, asleep in the same bed, was not roused. It can only be some foul sorcery. This way.